Welcome, Yogi Fam. It's Layla the Yogi here. Today we are going to do a different type of practice. It's going to be a meditation, but it's going to be one that's easy for you to do if you've never tried meditation before. It's a relaxation technique, or a bunch of techniques, I should say, for you to relax, and specifically for those of you who are about to experience an anxiety or depression spiral, or you can feel that negative, dense energy coming over you. Just being able to acknowledge your mental health, your emotional state, is the first step in acknowledging a spiral when you're going to have those spirals of negative thoughts, of self-doubt, or anxiety and stress, whether it's caused by something internal or external. So intrinsically, we know exactly when we are feeling overwhelmed. We know exactly when we're feeling that grief, that depression, and usually it stems from right here. It's not just a mental, psychological feeling. It's actually energy in motion, or emotion in our body. So when you feel that in your chest, or maybe it's your belly, wherever you feel it, you're going to notice that your posture starts to differ. You may feel a bit sweaty or tremory. It's all natural parts of a spiral. And if you're used to having panic attacks, it can feel like you're almost dying. So you want to make sure that you're in a safe space when you do this meditation, because it's going to bring you back to the present moment. And I'd encourage you to turn on this video whenever you need to. Maybe it's first thing in the morning, maybe it's in the evening, maybe it's after something that has triggered you has happened. And just know that I am here for you. I'm here for you to experience meditation, and I'm here for you to experience your full potential and full relaxation. And it is totally safe just to let out any emotion that comes up throughout this process, because it is a process, and I encourage you to use this video whenever you need to. So let's get started.
We use our belly most of the time to breathe, our diaphragm, and we're taking the attention to the diaphragm. So I'd like you just to sit or lay down when you notice that this spiral is happening. And first declare that you're in a safe space. There's nothing around you that's going to harm you. And just to simply listen to my voice, know that I'm here for you in this moment. I'm here to support you. And I'm here to clear that stressful, dense, or anxious energy that is swirling in your mind and in your body. At this point, you may still be having thoughts. You may still be having a racing pulse and sweaty hands, or you may be craving or itching to do something else that is causing you suffering in this moment. So just gently close your eyes, roll your shoulder blades down your back, notice your posture, notice your body, and start to soften the space between your eyebrows. Let your face melt from ice, firmness, to softness, more like water. And then allow all the tension in the face to evaporate like a mist. And do that same process with the throat. You may notice that when you're in a spiral, the throat can become really constricted, as if you're trying to express something, let something out. Imagine this tension start to melt and then evaporate. Now take both hands to your chest. Take a deep breath in. Fill up your chest and your belly. Take a deep breath out. This is all you have to do. Just listen to my voice. Focus on your breath. Let your hands melt into your chest. Take one more deep breath in. This time hold, feel the tension in the chest and then allow it to melt as you exhale. And then allow it to evaporate as if all that anxious, stressful, fearful energy, fearful thoughts start to evaporate. And really believe and know that you no longer need them. And take your hands to your belly, take a deep breath in and out. Let all tension release, let it evaporate. And then allow your hands to fall. Relax your shoulders, relax your arms, soften the low back, the entire back body, and then start to move that sensation of evaporation down your legs as you breathe deeper and deeper and send your breath, the energy from the breath, all the way down the legs to the toes. And imagine the energy from the feet dissipating down into the earth. Take one more deep breath in. Let it fill you all the way to the top of your head. And on your exhale, let it out through the mouth. If any emotions come up, just let it out. It's important not to suffocate in difficult emotions, not to label them as bad or good, and to fully accept whatever arises. Take one more inhale. Exhale, let it out through the mouth, soften through the throat. Now just simply notice the feeling of the breath. Just the feeling of it, no forcing. I'm going to talk to you a little bit about fear. So you may notice when you're in a spiral, there's some sort of fear. One thought that voice in your head says, maybe it's a few thoughts, a few ruminations of the past or the future that's not even here yet. And where does that fear come from? Keep breathing softly. Just try not to think about it, but intuitively question where that fear comes from. Imagine holding it in the palm of your hands. Now on your next exhale, bring your hands to your heart. Softly and gently, maybe rubbing that area in a spiral motion, and replace the fear with courage. And just like how we questioned where fear comes from, noticing where the energy, the feeling of being courageous in your life, where does that come from? It does not come from being successful in the pursuit of perfection, of being perfect. It's not, it's not possible to be completely perfect. Knowing that courage is feeling the fear, but living, but being your unique self anyways. Now feel that energy, feel what I just said, enter your mind and enter your body as you breathe softly. knowing that no one is you, and that is your inherent power. Feel that power as you release your hands. Feel it in your fingertips, swirling in your palms. Now take your attention to the space between your eyebrows. Notice if you feel a spiral there, tingling. That is where you hold your wisdom, your intuition, when you're about to do something that's self-sabotaging, that's a rumination from the past, a past version of you, when you're about to take that or do that. It speaks to you. It's that feeling that comes over you that says, this is wrong. I deserve better. I know better. And I'm going to show up differently for myself today. Taking a moment to feel that intuition. And then let it go. And start to imagine a lightness, an overall clearing energy pour over you. I have a crystal here. It's selenite. And it has very clearing energy. So if you can imagine, since we're not in person, that I am sweeping this energetically over your head and clearing any negative energy, you can imagine the light coming off of it as white, as blue, as clearing, whatever you'd like it. Maybe it's a mist. Now I'm going across your forehead, to your spot of intuition, going around the crown of your head, down your face, down your chest, down your belly, around the bottoms of your feet, and then back up again through your back body. Take a deep breath in, exhale through the mouth. You are cleansed. You're allowed to release any pent-up emotions and process them. Let them flow through you like water. I also have this amethyst here. Really pretty purple. You don't have to look. You can keep your eyes closed and then maybe look at it later. But this promotes peace because it has a very calming energy if you were to hold it in your hands. And just imagine me going over your forehead in a circular motion, not literally rubbing it on you, but in front of your forehead. Imagine it coming down your face, and imagine it at your throat. Imagine it going back and forth, and just tapping it so you can hear. Imagine it going across your shoulders, across your heart space in a circular motion, at your belly, and then I have one more crystal I'm going to use to harmonize your energy because everything is energy, in case you're wondering why I like using crystals. They harmonize your energy and they create frequencies. They give off these frequencies that are different than the frequencies, the vibration that the cells in our bodies are working at. So this is really cool emulated quartz. Very shiny. You can sort of hear the little edges of the crystal. Now imagine me pressing this against your heart. You can imagine its energy as white or blue or pink, starting to swell up your heart with warm energy. And imagine the energy traveling up your throat into your face, down your back body, down your feet, up your shins, the fronts of your legs, up your belly, your diaphragm, chest, your clavicles, deltoids, your shoulders, your traps, the back of your neck. Imagine it going in this sphere motion down the back body and through the front body. You are so much stronger than you think. May this energy provide you with strength. And you are so much more powerful than what your mind tells you. You are not that. You are the awareness of how powerful you are. And just let that sink in. I'm going to play the singing bowl to allow your heart, that energy center at your chest, to fully open. Imagine a lightness traveling down, dripping down your entire body. Imagine this vibration filling every cell in your body. So that's what that one sounds like. I usually use that in an energy clearing session, meditation session, where we work with the chakras, the energy centers. So just let that sink in. Notice how you are fully surrendering and trusting your body. It is so much more intuitive and wiser than you think. It knows every little thing about you. And just trust that. Trust the power in that. I'm going to get a lighter. Still soften. Still allow your eyes to be closed. Allow yourself to melt further into your body. And what I usually do in meditation is I light a little bit of sacred smoke. Not only helps you concentrate on your breath, but it adds a different vibe to your entire practice. You'll notice when you smell something that smells really good, you start to relax, or it reminds you of something. That is that positive energy entering your mind and your body. So this is Palo Santo. Also, if you're Spanish, you may know what it is. Hispanic. And I'd usually use that just to clear your energy, allow you to relax and smell it. And I'm going to, oh, you can hear. That's the wood. Now we're just going to put that out. And I have little rose petals here. You can hear that. It's a little bit of relaxation. It's really satisfying. Some people are relaxing, calming. And they give off a really good smell. Take one more deep breath in. Let it fill you from the crown of your head. Let it drip down your body as you exhale. Like a wave of positive, accepting, and calm emotion. Self-growth is a process, but what we often don't realize is that it's more of a journey and it has its ups and downs. And when you feel like you're about to spiral and reach out for something outside of yourself, remind yourself of this feeling. Know that your body has everything that it needs to fully relax, and that the growth doesn't end here. It's a daily, weekly, monthly practice. Not only does it help our emotional and mental capacity, but it allows us to realize who we truly are and receive, believe, and feel how we are meant to feel. Our authenticity, how we are as people for real. Thank you for receiving how you are meant to feel today. May you notice the harmony of your mind, your body, your energy, your heart, your spirit. May you bring this energy into your life. No longer play small, but to expand your courage and to release silly and negative fear. Let go of what no longer serves you and what no longer serves your body. Make room for growth. Take that leap. Take that chance. Reach out. Start to practice. Start to do things that make you feel alive. When you're ready, take a deep breath in, exhale through the mouth, and gently open the eyes. Thank you so much, yogis, for joining me today. This is just as blissful for me as I hope it was for you. And know that when I speak about growth, I do mean it. It's a process. We don't wake up and become this beautiful butterfly. We have to go through a little bit of transition, uncomfort, fear. Maybe we're scared of doing meditation, or yoga, or fitness, or health, or starting to eat healthier, drink more water, whatever it is. Know that you were supported in this journey, if not by anyone else in your life, by me. And know that you inspire me every day to keep doing what I'm doing. Namaste. Peace, yogis, from Layla the Yogi.